And I suppose there's a lot of hopes for a girl.
Well, yeah, it's kind of mixed. Michael really is excited and expecting a girl, and mm-hmm. I'm kind of, either way, it doesn't matter.
Either way,
to me.
It doesn't matter.
No.
You'll end up with a team, one way or the other.
How big a family did you come from?
I have five sisters, and Michael has five total in his family.
Okay.
So five and six.
So there's a good chance you may have a girl.
Correct.
Are you planning on that big a family?
Well, not really. We kind of both, we've been thinking about four apiece. He wants four, I want four. And that's
so
really
that's
about
eight.
It. Well, no. I'm sorry, four total.
Okay. Oh, good at math.
So that's about
great.
It. So maybe one more from
yeah.
here.
And it always seems to happen that when you're expecting that you either move or that you're doing some renovations on your house just before the baby comes. It just seems to happen
yeah.
that way. You're building your dream house
yes,
now.
Yeah, we're in the process of building. We broke ground about 2-3 weeks ago, and we're looking at a 2-year project. So it's quite a ways away, but we're very excited mm-hmm. about it.
Why was that important for you?
Well, because right now we really don't have any privacy where we are, and we constantly have people coming to the house, and they're asking for autographs, and it's
difficult.
Do they
come up to the door?
They come to the door. They ring the bell.
Lucille
oh,
Ball
my
tells
gosh.
Of people walking in her house
oh.
in Beverly Hills.
So the baby's asleep, and
yes,
the doorbell rings.
Bell rings, and yeah. it's distracting.
Well, you said you're the heavy in all this, where you're the one that has to go out and say, that's it?
Right. It's like I draw the line when people start to come to the home. And it's like, if I don't do that, we will never have any privacy. We have to have some, and that's why I drive along at home.
The basketball schedule is such a lengthy one. It's almost year-round, because even when they have time off, they're off doing other things, speaking engagements and so on. How do you keep the family together? How do you keep the... Well, now that we're all talking about family values in this mm-hmm. political year, but how do you do it?
It's difficult, but we make time to spend together. We during the off season, when Michael has time, we do things as a family. Even during the season, I take the boys to the games, and afterwards we'll have dinner mm-hmm. or something like that. So we make the time to be together.
Have you ever been anywhere where Michael's persona was not an issue? Never have. So given all the nice things and the perks and all the wonderful things and a way of life that basketball gives you, what about the downside, if any?
Well, the downside is probably the fact of the lack of the lack of privacy, because we can't go anywhere. You just mentioned that we have not been anywhere where he is not recognized, and someone always feels that's their only opportunity to see him, and they feel it's okay to interrupt.
Maybe, excuse me, I may be having a problem with my mic, so Sarah, why don't you ask?
Okay. Well, you know what? I'd love to hear how you met Michael, because Gary and I were talking before the show a little bit about some of the rumors that were around that you were a groupie.
Oh, right.
Or you fell in front of the car.
Right. And
oh,
that he was going to run over me. I know. I heard that one, too. Well, we have a mutual friend that introduced us, and I have a girlfriend that I went to a basketball game with these other guys. And afterwards, we all went to dinner. And the guy introduced us to Michael at dinner that night. And then I saw him after that, and that's how we really met. We have a mutual friend.
And it's still romance after how many years? Three?
3 years of marriage, 8 years of being together. Yeah.
Yeah. Now, recently, a commercial was done where you took part, as well as Michael's dad and Michael. We're going to run it and take a look at it. It was for what, Hanes?
Hanes, yes.
Okay,
the
let's
Hanes
take a look at that.
Your acting debut.
Are these your hands?
Mm-hmm.
Son, is there a reason why you wear them?
Definitely.
Mm-hmm. Think Mom would like me in these?
Maybe.
Just wait till we get our hands on you.
It's very nice.
I didn't see you in there. Where?
I was the one that came out and gave him the kiss.
Yeah, she gave a kiss.
I had one line, definitely.
How did you handle that?
It was fun. I enjoyed it. There were people on the set that made us very comfortable. That was his father's first time, too. And we all had a good time.
Now, I must ask you, Juanita, as if basketball wasn't enough in terms of demanding time for Michael, what about golf? Are you a golf widow?
I am a golf widow. Oh. However, we just celebrated our anniversary, and I got a set of golf clubs.
Good for you.
Well, what a romantic gift.
Can't beat them, join them.
That's right.
Okay. Our guest, Juanita Jordan, thank you so much.
Thanks, Juanita.
Juanita.
Congratulations to you.
Thank you.